أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Most of it done, again, the reality for us in this ocean of marifa that we're traversing into the sun. And just recently they made a scientific vehicle that they say traversed into the sun. And alhamdulillah, that same theory is Shamsul Arifin, is the sun of all knowledges, and the reality and the source of all these realities that are emanating, the Divinely reality that emanate from the heart of the universal soul. And that is the sun for all created universes, not even the sun that we see here, but the sun that is in the center of all created universes. We are traversing with our soul into the reality of that. And as a result, Allah has for us to come to this ocean of Divinely love, and only by that Divinely love I was a treasure wanting to be known. And Allah wants to be known in this Divinely ocean of ishq and muhabbat. And we said before that it can only be dressed by the beatific character. If the character is gold, it can carry that reality. If the character is plastic and styrofoam, it burns right through. That reality burns through it, and it's not a vessel in which to carry that reality. So the turuqs come to teach us the adab and the manners, and then Allah has us to remind us that your path is to be the moon. So exemplify yourself and take your example from my creation, because Allah said the signs within you and signs on the horizon. And many times they've taught that the sign upon the horizon is much easier to understand, because people may not be reflecting internally truthfully to themselves. But on the horizon we can't manipulate. So the horizon teaches us, because this Allah's direct hand, so you look to the moon as what you should be. So it doesn't matter what a guru teach, what is this teacher teaching, what is that one teaching, because everyone has a philosophy. But Allah's teaching that the teacher should be an exemplar and an example from the moon. And the teacher should not be claiming any light of his own, any power of his own, anything of his own. And if he does it right, then you negate yourself and you're merely a reflection of the source and you are not the source.
Assalamu alaikum. We hope that you're enjoying the video, inshallah. Just a request that you help us continue to make such amazing Islamic content, inshallah. Share this video with your friends and loved ones, subscribe to the channels, and donate. Every bit helps. Jazakallah khair, and we will return to the program.
So the moon is giving us that example. We benefit from its light, our the tides of this earth go up and down, our blood, our psychology, everything is affected by moonlight. And you look at the moon and it claims nothing, it shows itself in a very casual appearance, and that becomes the example of the path. That Allah on this journey, you know, you keep stopping at these different months. So when this tour stops on this month, it's all about the understanding of the qamar and the moon. That your guidance and who you should be is like a moon that tested, tried, because you look to the moon, it's been battered, it has been attacked by every type of difficulty, there's no structures upon it. As a result, it hasn't had a a structure that's extremely visible, not like the earth, and as a result it reflects the sunlight in perfection. And all of these the Dajjal will be attacking, all these haqqaiqs. They describe the moon as something else, that's like a ship and a spaceship that's flowing, and there's this and there's that, and every haqqaiq is going to come in a different direction, and that becomes the great deceit. And Allah is reminding for us the shamsi wal qamar. Shamsi is the diya, and the fire is the fire that Nabi Musa was moving towards. And all of creation Allah describes to them that you move to that light, but you have to have the character of the moon of qamar. So, qamar nurun wa shamsun diyaun, that the sun is a fire nar, and the moon is a light of reflection, not a source itself. And that's what we talked about the nights before of juzbah, of magnetism. So you're not a source of knowledge, you're not a source of light, because at this point Allah is clarifying before you go any further on your journey is that you're nothing. So you continuously negate the self that, "I'm nothing Ya Rabbi, whatever you bestow upon me it's merely a reflection from the source." If you're not of a magnetic connection and you didn't make the connection and negate yourself, you're reflecting a little from the source but more from you. And that's what some people have little bit of understanding, and they mix it into something as a confusing dish that nobody can get guided by, and many will be lost by it. Because too much of themselves is reflecting and little from the source. So the moon then is a proof that you have to have been tested. So you don't just appear on the scene and you go out and you say, "I'm a moon." So no, who smashed you? So what type of difficulties and calamities and testing and all sorts of… That's why the tariqah is based on tarbiyah. The tarbiyah is when the shaykh, when he signs an ijazah, he's basically signing that, "I have flipped this person all over the place, put him in every type of difficult situation, as a result they still came out with that credibility, and as a result we are sending that support." So it's not something that's… the whole understanding is that when you want to reach to a reality, the reality is teaching everybody about itself. That these are stages in which the servant negates themselves. They've been tested in negation, they've been tested with difficulties, and their shaykhs taught them, "Be patient, have good character, talk kindly." Even they've posted recently, "We entered into this moon," immediately people whom are inspired and maybe not inspired, but the shaykh's overwhelming inspiration pushes them and talks about who's one whom has good character. And it was a dialogue between Shaykh Nazim and Shaykh Daghestani. And Shaykh Nazim asked Shaykh Daghestani, "Who's somebody who has good character?" And the person who has good character, does he complain? And Shaykh Daghestani's response is, "Absolutely not, because they're talking of the good character of awliya, that the one whom been trained and has good character must always remind themselves there's no complaining." That the contentment of the servant is that if they know that they're submitting, they know they have a divine love, they know that they're in the hands of Allah, who are you complaining to? And what are you complaining for? But if you're not one with good character, he described, then you're like a person with like boils and blisters all over you. That as soon as somebody touches you, you're screaming and yelling all sorts of things, because it's just you're filled with that difficulty all over yourself. But the one whom is in contentment and been trained with tarbiyah, he knows that nobody going to relieve him. He doesn't need to tell everybody that they're in difficulty, I'm like this, I'm like that, I'm like this. Why? Because nobody can help him other than Allah. So means all these are the characteristics of the moon. You know, people want to complain and tell everybody their problems, their sickness, their difficulties. For what? Who can relieve it from you but Allah. So the good character is then they learn not to talk. So they say, oh, when this person's in difficulty, you don't even know they're in difficulty, so I always thought your condition was good. But that's what you're supposed to think, because you're not the one who can help my condition or worsen my condition. So they live in an ocean of taslim in the hands of Allah. Or they wish and inspire to be like that, and this is what their shaykhs taught to them.
Insan al-Kamil by author and spiritual guide Shaykh Nurjan Mirahmadi describes that in order to be known, the Divine created a sublime treasure for all of creation. The glorious light and soul of the Insan al-Kamil, Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Vast universes, including every particle in existence, came into manifestation through this all-encompassing ocean of perfection. Order on Amazon.com.
Allah wants to bring what's hidden within the servant and bring it out. What's sickness within them, if Allah doesn't send that light upon them, that pushes out all the badness. قُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلُ. Right? So when the haqq is going to come, is the lights of Allah reflect upon all of the moons of this nation. Their lights reflect upon this earth, and the truth comes when it hits the falsehood of everybody's personality. They're not sitting there together happy. The light comes in and by its force pushes everything out. Blisters, boils, sickness, everything has to come out. Zahuqan, Allah that the falsehood you carry within us is all of a falsehood, and it's nothing to withstand in the presence of the light of truth. It can't fight back. The falsehood has nothing that it can hold on to, and immediately is obliterated, coming out with all of these sicknesses and all these difficulties. So then this journey is into that light and into that reality, and even Allah have servants that not been taught or they're not understanding to tune in to get the understanding of their path, and Allah loves His creation equally, so they're all going through it. But sad for the one whom doesn't understand the situation, because not following the coordinates of the heart to go and sit with those who have guidance. So the one whom Allah guides is a tremendous blessing. Because then they can stop and understand that every step of this difficulty, I'm not being attacked, Allah loves me and Allah wants me to be patient. So He gives us all these coordinates, is a huge blessing in our lives. Because on the other side people are equally receiving all of these same difficulties, but they have no understanding whatsoever what's going on, and just from every direction there's some sort of craziness happening. Until they mentally break down, physically break down, and every type of faculty within them is just not functioning anymore. Go in, go out, go in, go out, you're sick, you're cold, you lost your job, you lost your… people will jump off bridges. So the true ni'mat and the blessings of Allah that sit with them and they'll teach you what's coming, what tajallis are coming, what lights are coming, what verse of Qur'an is dressing, what chapter of Holy Qur'an is dressing this universe, this earth, because those are the unspoken, uncreated words of Allah, created words of Allah that coming through the Muhammadan heart, which means is the isharat and the guidance of Sayyidina Muhammad for the entire universe. The entire universe is taking its commands, and those are all the ulul amr from all the categories that Allah has created of the servants of the Divine, from the angels to the spirits to the jinn to the saints, all of them are following that command. And that Allah is sending these lights upon this earth, and that to cleanse and wash out Fath Abwaab As-Sama, we're opening these lights from paradises and from the soul's realities to wash out all the badness. Like when the house is dirty and you turn the hose on and everything, you just wash out all the marble floors, wash everything out, and all the dirt that is coming out because it's not going to be clean. And that becomes the sicknesses of mankind, these dirts, that they're poisons and toxins that come out of their body and their spirit. Because this insan and this human is like a castle asking for the Divinely Light to enter into it. But don't think that your castle is not being attacked. It has already an enemy inside trying to open all the doors for all the devils on the outside to come in and ravage this kingdom, for this servant is going to fall. Because if he should reach his reality, he's a king amongst men. It was a chess game, shatranj was that understanding, that's why Islam brought that. That you're a kingdom, but yet not your king has arrived, right? You just have this Divinely Palace appearing on this earth, because every human that arrived upon this earth was from a heavenly kingdom. The kings of paradise, the beloved creation of Allah, of God Almighty, put them onto this earth, so they're like a palace. And those whom they gave themselves to shayateen and to badness, their palace became for nefarious and for demonic purposes, and that palace was lost. But the battle is that your palace is to be clean and purified, your being to be clean and purified, so that Allah, God Almighty, to place a king upon your throne, upon your heart. And when Allah knights you and gives you that kingdom, gives you that light, that's the hadith of Prophet ﷺ, that they're like 1,000 men, that those of whom rijal who reached their ahad and their covenant, they are like 1,000 men. Their ulum, their knowledge, their lights, their reality, because on earth then they become crowned like a king. And that's the whole battle, for the battle of the insan and the person is within. So they're continuously fortifying, continuously battling all the creatures inside their castle. How can you fight outside when the creature already inside is smashing everyone, killing everything inside? You can't fight like that, nobody would fight like that, the fight is inside. And that's why Prophet ﷺ described that the inner battle, why? Because in the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, just the mere light of the prophetic reality annihilated all of that. Could you stand in the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ and that light with love, and bringing that love, that light would enter and annihilate everything. But he told the companions the time that when I'm not amongst you physically, but I'm always with you, but when I'm not with you physically, that is your greatest battle for the nation that are coming, that will be following my nation. Why? Because they got completely possessed with all sorts of shayateen, and they're not bringing the light inside them. They don't have that reflection to destroy every type of evilness. So then they have to fight and go inside and fight and struggle and do their muraqabah, do their energy, do their practices. And that was the reality of wudu, that was the reality of salah, that was the reality of everything. So these courses are teaching all the basic Islam, but giving you the depth of its understanding. So that your nafs don't say, why I gotta wash, oh why Islam has washing? Well, because it's all based on these energies. How could you not wash your house, your clothes, yourself, anything? It would be filled with filth. Then what would be the purpose of your praying if you're all filthied out? So it means the reality of wudu, the reality of salah, all of this is in these teachings of energy and the cleansing and destroying the inner enemy to bring out the outer reality and then begin to go after the outer reality. Because once the inner reality is being clean and those demons are lessened and destroyed, then what happens? Then there's a very powerful battle for the outside. So that's why then these difficulties, these testings, and the people whom they're compliant, complacent or happy with their bad character, then that's a difficult, difficult thing. So people like it, they don't like it, they don't want to hear the understanding and the teachings, Allah will clean. Because the bad character means there's still demonic forces inside and they're not letting go. And Allah will clean the servant. Those who give themselves to demonic forces, then they have given themselves, there'll be no more gray. It will be white and black. Those whom have given themselves to the darkness, they are fully committed to that darkness. And those whom have given themselves to the light, Allah will intensely purify them to be worthy of being in the presence of Sayyidina Mahdi salam, inshaAllah. We pray that Allah give us a hikmah and a wisdom and a himmah, a zeal in which to accomplish these realities that are coming in very strong. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifoon, wa salaamun al mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Bi hurmati Muhammad al Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al Fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of Divinely Knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Sheikh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input, and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, nurmuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Sheikh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide. From feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. NurMuhammad.com/donate.